And I just started crying on the phone. I fell to my knees and I just, all the weight and stress and just came out.
Like, some actors get roles and they kind of like, they do the role, but like some actors like become the role and really take it to another level. Right. And that's with you on the Steve Harvey Show.
Yes.
As Lovita Alize Jenkins Robinson.
Yes, you got it right.
Okay, that's a lot. So she was from the South, was that her? Because that name sounds like a Jenkins.
Right, so her family was from the South, for sure. She was from the hood there in Chicago.
Okay.
But her family, her roots were in the South, for sure.
How did you get that particular role?
Again, going through the audition process. So I have been auditioning. At that point, I had done more roles. I had booked a lot more roles up to that point, but it was still just like one-offs, like a lot of sitcoms, but it was just like one episode.
Living Single,
Sinbad. Maybe it wasn't a lot of roles. Maybe not. Oh, Family Matter.
Okay. Right.
So Family Matter, I did like 3 episodes, I think. So that was the first time that I did more than one little pop-off. And then so after that, I had the audition for the Steve Harvey Show. Again, going through our same acting audition process. Mm-hmm. You go in, you read for the casting director, you get past that point. Then you come in and read for the producers, get past that point, read for the director. Then you read for the network. And I will say, from my very first audition, I felt super comfortable with doing this role.
Okay.
Very comfortable.
Why is that?
Because she was from my neighborhood. She was a girl that I grew up with. She was a girl that I knew. I literally based her attitude and sass and her high-pitched voice off of some girls in my neighborhood. So I kind of like stole their identity for Lovita, but it's like a mixture of girls. So they can't say, oh, you just stole that from me. Nope, it's like about 3 of you in one.
Right, because they're going to watch this and be like, oh, what?
Right. So I felt comfortable right away. And so for every audition, I was like, this is easy breezy. I'd go in, say my word, da-da-da. I was just feeling her. I was just felt like, and if they weren't going to cast her through me, it was just going to be a different character. But this character, like, this was all me. And so, you know, you go through the process of auditions. And by that last audition, which was probably number 4 or 5, I can't remember. And I knew this was the last point. It was either now or never. This is where they were going to make their decision in front of the network. So it's like network execs, producers, writers, the director, everybody's there. And I go in audition. Oh, and when you go for a network read in television, you sign your deals first. So everybody there has signed their deal and they know what they're going to make if they're the chosen one.
Wait a second. How long do they let that kind of harbor on you? Is that like...
Right. It's within the week.
So you knew your life was going to change?
If I got chose.
Wow.
And so did all the other girls that were going in for the network read. So it's like the most stressful time. It's like you're trying to stay focused on this character, but then you're thinking, oh my God, I can get out of debt. I could do this. I could buy a new car. You know, you just started spending that money.
How did that information affect how you was moving? Were you like staying up late studying? Like, what was...
So, I mean, this was like my 4th or 5th audition. So I knew the material back and forth. Now it was just a matter of me calming my nerves when I went into the room, not letting myself get so nervous, you know, with the information now that I'm equipped with.
Mm-hmm.
So I go in for this audition. I go in, I meet the execs and whatever. And that's the other thing. They're like talking, like asking you questions. Like, I don't want to fucking talk because then you're getting me out my game. It's like, I just want to stay focused. Let me just come in and do Lovita and then leave. And then you can ask me some questions. So you got to go in, you got to talk, you got to be nice, you got to do all this stuff. And then they're like, okay, go.
Mm-hmm.
So anyway, so I did my read. And I felt like I sucked. I was like, oh, I blew it. I got all the way right here to the door and I did not deliver like I knew I can deliver. So I was beating myself up the whole day. And then my agent called me and she was like, well, how do you feel like you did? And I was like, it really wasn't my best. And she was like, well, you got it. And I just started crying on the phone. I fell to my knees and I just, all the weight and stress and just came out.
What was going on in your life at that time?
Just a struggling actor, living, you know, bill to bill, calling home. Can I borrow some money? Can you pay for my phone bill this month? You know, just struggling. So again, just to get that call and this be the one, like finally it was me. Because as an actor going through this process, you've been here before. I had tested before, but this was the first time that I felt like it was mine. I really felt like it was mine until that last audition. And I felt like I fucked up. So, you know, it was just the weight of all of that and all those no's from all the previous years, all those no's.
Right.
Didn't matter anymore. So that's what all the tears and the thanking God and praising Him was for in that moment.
Right. Who came up with the line, SETI? Was that improv or was that written out?
I think it was scripted.
Wow.
It's like Winifred Hervey, who was the showrunner and head writer. She was amazing. She wrote a great character and they allowed me to, you know, put my stank on it. But she really did. She gave me the material.
Mm-hmm.
She gave it to me. And that was the only way I saw it to be. I don't know why I saw her with this annoying voice. I don't know why. I just...
So that was like your twang on it.
That was based on a girl in my neighborhood.
That definitely. I think that was the character was known for that.
Yeah.
Either SETI or the high. It was like those two combined.
Yeah.
And I can't see it without the non-high-pitched voice. It wouldn't be the same effect.
Yeah.